Hello, everybody. This is Nels Cline, and this is First Look.
Hello, I'm Don Woods, the president of Blue Note Records, and our guest on First Look today is one of the most eclectic musicians on the planet, Nels Cline. He's probably most recognized as a member of the band Wilco, but he's collaborated with an incredibly diverse range of musicians, from Wadada, Leo Smith, and Julius Hemphill, to Tanarwin and Tedeschi Trucks Band, and Medeski Martin and Wood, and Tim Byrne, and Wayne Kramer, and Ramblin' Jack Elliott. No one's got a resume like that. But he's also got 30 or 50 albums of his own out there, and his latest recording, his third for Blue Note, is Share the Wealth by the Nels Cline Singers. Good to see you, man.
Hey, great to see you, Don. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thanks for being here, man. It's such a cool record, and I love this version of the Singers so much. Let's talk about the band and what distinguishes the Nels Cline Singers from some of your other ensembles.
Well, I started those Singers as a trio about 18 years ago with Scott Amendola on drums and electronics, and at that time, the bassist Devin Hoff, and it sort of meandered over the years into various areas, all of them rather electric, but not exclusively electric, and what I like to politely call jazz rock and impolitely call fusion.
Totally.
But that's my music, you know, I mean, it's just kind of how I do it. And I just got this idea a couple of years ago to expand the band, primarily because I was really becoming more and more self-conscious and uneasy about being the only treble clef voice. And I needed a foil, I felt, you know, just somebody to play off of, more sound, just more depth, orchestrationally speaking. Skerrick, I've known, he's playing tenor saxophone and electronics. I met Skerrick maybe 18 years ago, actually. I was playing with Mark Isham, in fact, Silent Way Project up at Bumbershoot in Seattle. And there was this guy playing electric saxophone in a trio playing all Black Sabbath covers in a band he was leading called Crack Sabbath. And he's got a lot of interesting band names.
All the electronics and all the new people, you must have to rehearse for months to make a record like this. How does this happen?
Kidding, right? No, we didn't rehearse at all. We didn't. In fact, I had barely finished the material and was still writing charts, horribly written charts, I might add. Poor Brian, trying to write piano parts for him, just saying, wait, what register is this? You know, no, we just learned the material that I had. In fact, there was a song called Share the Wealth that it just didn't quite cut the mustard for me, so it didn't make the cut. But I like the title.
Great title.
It has more meaning for me than a song title. So we just recorded what I had and did a bunch of improvising. And the improvising I initially was going to use as source material for almost sound collages, of shorter duration by far than what's on the record. When I heard these improvised bits, I was really pleased with the music. And for a band that's never played a gig in public and probably won't for quite a while now, I was astonished and I just thought, wow, I guess I have another too long record on my hands, you know? Story of my life.
Let's talk about Segunda for a second. I'm going to ask you like a geeky question just because I've never actually gone up on a stage and looked at what you're playing through or been in the studio with you. The guitar sounds are so incredible on that, man. The energy is so amazing. Do you like bring a bunch of vintage amps to the studio? Do you have all kinds of pedals?
Well, there's a lot of pedals, yeah. I'm kind of known for that at this point, I guess, which is sometimes a little irritating, but it is what I have. I guess this was my big pedal board and one little studious amp, 112, you know, 20 watt amp. Yeah. We maxed out the bunker. We had so much equipment in there. I don't mean multiple amps, but I mean, just to get all Brian's keyboards and all Ciro's percussion took up most of that space. Mm-hmm. And so the amps, the bass and guitar amp were next to each other in a little closet. And the sound on Segunda is just some overdrive and then a distortion pedal, which is perhaps embarrassingly the signature, my signature distortion pedal that was never really commercially available.
Well, let's play some of Segunda for the folks, shall we?
Yeah, thanks. Good.
That's Segunda from the brand new album by the Nels Cline Singers called Share the Wealth. Let's play Beam Spiral, man. I want to show people a bit of the super trippy video that Yuka made.
Right. Okay, enjoy. The song's rather episodic, and so it definitely doesn't end where it starts. And Yuka's video really addresses, I think, all the dynamic shifts and the what is ultimately a climax, you know, it's building, and I think she killed it, like, just crushed it.
Yeah. How much of the structure is planned out ahead of time on that song?
It's probably one of the most rigidly planned pieces on the record, but the beginning is just cued written material for primarily the electric piano and guitar and later bass that are essentially variations on the almost trance-like repetition that happens later when the pounding eighth notes start building and building. So in between each one of those written sections is completely free improvisation.
Let's play some of it. Beam Spiral. That's Beam Spiral by the Nels Cline Singers from the new album, Share the Wealth. I love the last song on the record, Passed Down. It's such a moody song, and I love hearing you play acoustic guitar too, man. Let's talk about that one.
That song it's very personal in a way, and it relates to another piece on the record called Nightstand. Passed Down is a kind of folk song, I guess. The origin of the song came out of, I would say, without sounding super dramatic, intense grief over an old friend's suicide. Nightstand was also a kind of coping mechanism. He was not a guy, he was a heavy, heavy music guy. A lot of people in the music industry knew him, and he was just one of the most amazing people one could ever meet in life, but who struggled mightily with depression and despair. I just wrote both those pieces to cope with what I was feeling. And the thing about Passed Down, I guess, is that it's very direct. I had written a whole bunch of more material, actually, and just got rid of it and just kept it a lot simpler. And the little guitar solo section in the middle when it goes into rubato is, I guess, a grotesque example of cultural appropriation. I'm sorry, everybody, but I listen to a lot of music from Mali, and I listen to a lot of music from Pakistan, and from India, and I listen to the blues. So it comes out sometimes like that. And also, it's a great example of Skerrick's tenor sound and how he can actually remind me of Pharoah Sanders or Gatto Barbieri, and when I was listening to those guys in the 70s and have this huge sound. It's very gratifying.
Let's play that. It's Passed Down. Passed Down by the Nels Cline Singers from the brand new album, Share the Wealth. When we were talking about Passed Down, you mentioned Nightstand as being a companion piece. And I love that track so much.
Well, thank you. I mean, it's very odd. It's an odd piece in that it's initially the theme is essayed by just tenor saxophone and piano, Skerrick and Brian. The writing, if I were to be, I guess, not humble, I could say it's my attempt to get close to a Wayne Shorter feeling, his incredible ballads and his sound, actually, his tenor sound. And in fact, I feel Wayne kind of drifting through much of this record.
Let's play it. Nightstand. That's Nightstand by the Nels Cline Singers from the brand new album, Share the Wealth. You mentioned that the title Share the Wealth had a special meaning for you.
Oh, you know, I think that people will probably read it as, wow, it's a long record and we did a lot of playing in 2 days and there are these long pieces on the record. And so that's, I guess, a wealth of musical information. But I was actually, and still am, thinking about it more from a socialist point of view, which is just to say that I'm consistently troubled by the concentration of more and more wealth in the world among fewer and fewer individuals. And I dream of a society, you know, a society in which we take care of each other and we try to level the playing field and accentuate fairness and tolerance, and we talk to each other. And I just thought that Share the Wealth, coming from this, I'm just kind of a white suburban dude from West Los Angeles, you know, but in the wealthiest nation, that I'd like to see, or at least have people think about a different way to go than this sort of disparity that is, I think, ultimately going to have a worse and worse effect on society, on individuals, on communities. And I just want us to be more generous.
It's always good to see you. Congratulations on another beautiful album. And thank you so much for putting it out on Blue Note.
Well, God, Don, thank you. I mean, I have to say, I think the record has some extremes that many people do not associate with the current roster. So I feel honored as ever and thankful, grateful as ever. It's a thrill, and I just hope that we can get out eventually with the 6-piece singers and play for the people.
That'd be real nice. I'm sure it's coming. Share the Wealth by the Nels Cline Singers, available now. Thank you for joining us on First Look.
Thank you.
If you enjoyed First Look and would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon. That way, you'll be notified when we post our next video.